Hello, and welcome back to my channel. I'm Sweet Bats, and today I'll be taking this dead tired Gulia Yelps and turning her into Persona 5's top tier waifu, Tei Takemi. This doll already has her hair cut and head removed, as she was used as a mannequin for wig practice, and the body was used to try a painting technique that didn't quite work out, which you can still see remnants of. However, given the severe yellowing on her body, I think she's the perfect candidate for changing the skin tone to a more human-like one. Unfortunately, since this is from an older line and bought from someone who played with her a lot, the elastic leg joints are super loose and I don't really have a good fix for that. In any case, let's clean her up and get started on her procedure. Off camera, I wiped her face with acetone, airbrushed her with primer and Pale Flesh from the Vallejo Game Air line of airbrush paints, and primed her with a few layers of Mr. Super Clear. Be sure to use the proper protection when handling all these dangerous chemicals. Safety always comes first. This doll had a lot of firsts for me. It was the first time I had actually worked on an airbrushed face, as I actually started on this doll before Loyal, so getting used to how the paint took pastels, pencils, and erasers was a new experience. Additionally, finding the right amount to spray was difficult, and I definitely learned for next time to do multiple thin layers instead of trying to get even coverage in just two or three layers. It's not gonna happen, trust me. I ended up with several spots that were still showing primer through the colored paint, while others had far too much paint built up and didn't dry properly. So take your time on this and don't rush art. If it's worth doing, it's worth doing right. It was also my first time working with Gulia's mold, and it was more of a challenge than I expected. With some dolls, you have the ability to use that defined upper eyelid as the eyelid crease instead, and then draw a new upper lid around the middle of the eye shape, which looked fantastic on my past Scara and Rochelle's. Unfortunately, that wasn't the case with Gulia. The poor girl looked like her face was melting off. I knew there was no saving it, so I wiped her, re-airbrushed, and tried again. Interestingly enough, the paint dyed the vinyl, so Gulia got a very interesting skin tone that I had to end up covering up with the paint again. But I did debate getting a different Gulia head to work on and save this one for a different project. I decided against it, since I figured matching the body would be a pain. Oh well, on to round two. I started with a bit of light blushing and contouring, and add some eyeshadow with the Mungyo Soft Pastels. Takemi doesn't wear a lot of makeup, but it's pretty important to get makeup on the dolls so the features stand out better. Continuing with pastels, I lay down the basic shape of the eyebrows, then tidy the edges with an eraser. After I'm happy with the shape, I add details with the pencil before blending it out with a bit of pastel on the top. I sat down and watched a few other doll artists work on Gulia's, so I had a better idea of how to tackle the eyes as to not repeat my prior mistake. Once I feel like I have it down, I lightly sketch out the shape, go over it with the darker color once I'm confident of placement, and fill in the irises with a nice warm brown color. Next up is the lips, which get a light pink on them, keeping with the natural makeup look. Doing subtle makeup was a bit of a challenge, but I think it turned out alright. I added some shadows to the eyes since I felt that they were a little too large and wider than usual, since I wasn't used to this mold, and I hoped shadows would create the illusion of smaller eyes. My white pencils weren't sticking to the airbrushed head super well, so I watered down a bit of white acrylic paint and took a tiny brush and the steadiest hand I could muster to do the scleras. This should have been done before the irises, but I was thinking the pencil later wouldn't give me any trouble. Afterward, I carefully work on my nemesis, eyelashes. One day I'll get these to look super nice. If you have any helpful tips for eyelashes, please leave them in the comments. I'm always looking for ways to improve. I add some darker browns to the iris, and add the pupil, trying to mix both my style with the art style of Persona. I think it turned out okay, but I can definitely see room for improvement. Because Gulia doesn't have a defined eyelid, I draw it on myself with a brown pencil to get the look that I want. I brighten the eyes a bit with a lighter color in the iris, then add a bit more color to the pastels of the eyeshadows, cheeks, and lips. This is actually a new layer, and Mr. Super Clear has a tendency to dull the pastels, so it's good to go a bit bolder and brighter than what you want the end result to be. Taking a pink pencil, I add small details to the lips to make them a bit more lifelike. Finally, I add some lower lashes and shines to the eyes with white acrylic paint, then seal in my work with the final layer of Mr. Super Clear, and after that dries, I can gloss the eyes and lips, which I apparently don't have footage of. You may have already noticed how short this video is compared to some of my others. It seems like I didn't film a lot of this doll, or I lost the footage when moving files off my phone, so sorry for that. I worked on this doll off and on throughout the year, so I wouldn't be surprised if I lost the footage. Also, this doll was part of a Persona collaboration that kinda fell through, but I still had a really fun time chatting with the other members of the collab, even if it didn't end as planned. I decided to make both of her outfits, though I definitely had some issues with them. While I don't film the outfit creation process, I'll try to walk through everything. The rips in her leggings were made by cutting the fabric and gluing the pieces to the inside with liquid stitch. Her leggings ended up too long with the pattern I used, so I had to turn them inside out, re-sew them to the legs of my mannequin doll, then trim and fray check them before turning them right side out. For the blue dress, I painted the spider web well enough with this lovely Lumiere paint, but I used a pattern that required fabric with stretch, which I did not use, so I had to sew a panel onto the back so it would fit. I am pretty proud of her main outfit, and especially the shoes. I found some small button details at Michael's and added those to the front of the lab coat. Her pen was made with a piece of a wood skewer, and her badge clip was made with a staple from a TV box, clipped and bent to size, and painted purple, with just taped paper for her badge. I painted her nails red to match the in-game model, and then also painted her belt red. It's a strip of thin, leathery fabric with silver rivets also painted on. These lovely shoes were started off with help from Walker Colors channel for the base, and modified from there to what I needed. I basically glued thin leather strips with silver painted details to form most of the shoe and glued it to the base, making a Velcro closure in the back. I also later made her a black cropped leather jacket, a small bracelet from a folded piece of fabric, and some boots to fit over her leggings. Though some were modified for my needs, all the clothing patterns, except for maybe the leggings, were made by DG Requiem, so check out her Etsy shop to get these fantastic patterns for yourself. I also made her necklace from ribbon, silver and gold acrylic paint, a fine chain, and air dry clay. Third time's the charm on her hair, as the first wig was too voluminous, the second was a sloppy experimentation with a glue gun, and the third finally was satisfactory. I shaped some pieces with hair wax for the anime look, but watered down glue also works as well. Her wig is again made from acrylic yarn per Mozakito's tutorials, so head over to her channel if you want a more in-depth look on how to make these. Alright, I think it's about time to take a look at the finished product. While I'm super happy with parts of this, like her standard outfit and her wig, there's a lot I'm not pleased with, and I feel like it's mostly due to how long I worked on this. Since I started the face early in the year and have finished another doll in the meantime, I'm comparing it to my other work and seeing many areas I could improve. Additionally, with it being my first time using the airbrush, I definitely was impatient and rushing when I shouldn't have, and it shows. When I get some free time, I might revisit her and update her look, but I have a lot I'm excited to work on before that. A quick announcement before I end this video. I'm sure all of you know about the COPA stuff that's been brought up here on YouTube, and I'm still not entirely sure of what it means for this community. Last I looked, it states that working with dolls as a hobby would count as general audience content and not directed at kids, making it sound like the community would be allowed to remain on the main YouTube site. However, things can change at a moment's notice. Because of this, I'm considering opening a Patreon on a pay-what-you-want basis, and we'll move to uploading videos there if YouTube changes their mind and decides we're no longer welcome here. I've also considered streaming on Twitch, however, I almost feel that I'd be more boring than the sped up videos. What are your thoughts? Given how time intensive videos are, I'll be wanting to post them somewhere I can still interact with you, the viewers. I'll still be posting everything on Instagram, so you can access final pictures and any progress pictures I post for free, and I have no current plans for making anything other than videos exclusive elsewhere, such as sneak peeks or giveaways. Speaking of Instagram and giveaways, though, I'm getting close to 500 followers and have a fun and exciting giveaway planned for that milestone, so if you aren't following me yet, please do so. I'll put a link in the description. Thanks for sticking around another year, and I can't wait to share the next year, and hopefully decade and beyond, with you all. I hope you all had a fantastic holiday season and start 2020 off in the best way. I'll see you next time. Take care.